Hello YouTube, I just want to say that I am super excited to bring this information to you. I believe that there is a huge, huge need for this message, for deliverance to Christians, okay? And I'm going to say some things in this video that is probably going to upset you. And I pray that you fight against those feelings. And I pray that you fight against the thoughts that are going to come into your head. And first off, just because Satan puts an I in front of it, it doesn't make it your thought, okay? I'm stupid. I need to go do this right now. I can't watch this video. This guy is a moron. This guy is a false teacher, whatever. I'm going to put the evidence in front of you, okay? And I need you to be patient, and I need you to fight. Right now, this is your first lesson in warfare, okay, is listening to this teaching. Because I'm going to come against demonic theologies and philosophies that are prevalent in today's church, okay? Let's look at the fruit. Why is your Christian brother and sister suicidal? Why are they filled with depression? Why are they on antidepressants? Why are they addicted to drugs, to alcohol, to promiscuity? Why? Is this in a buffering that the enemy is coming against them from the outside? No. Are they being oppressed? They are, but that enemy has a foothold, a stronghold, a place inside them, okay? And demons are spiritual, we are physical, so the whole, like, you know, am I possessed or all that stuff, it's kind of stupid. I will tell you that Christians cannot be possessed, okay? So that should put a lot of you at ease. But to say that you can't be demonized on a scale to 1 to 9 and 10 being possession, but you're a 9, yeah. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. The enemy comes to steal from you. Steal your health, steal your family, steal your finances, steal your power, steal your faith, comes to kill you, comes to destroy you, okay? And what better adjectives than cancer? I mean, I'm just going to throw that out there. Cancer steals, cancer kills, cancer destroys. Am I right? But one of those demonic philosophies that you like to think that God is trying to teach you a lesson, that God is trying to teach you patience or faith. Yeah, God can use cancer in your life to teach you those things, but to say that God has given you cancer is an affront to anything biblical. You are breaking the Father's heart by thinking that, okay? So even thinking that, you don't even fight against the cancer. You don't even pray about it, because deep down, how much faith are you going to have that God's going to heal you this if he's using this to teach you a lesson? Okay, I'm going to show you that if you have cancer, or if you have diseases, or if you have sicknesses, or if you have depression, or if you have demons, or if you're being demonized, there is usually a legal right for that demon to be there. Okay? Please bear with me. This video should bring you hope, should bring you life, because I'm trying to get you back to even. Okay? You've lived your Christian life since birth, some of you, with generational curses and generational demons that came to you before you were even born. And so you've lived your whole life under a cloud of depression, or prone to addictions, all right? And a lot of you have been discouraged. You know, God, why aren't you helping me out? Why aren't you hooking me up? I'm so powerless. I'm weak. I'm sucking resources from the church rather than giving to the world. God wants you on the front lines. God wants you in the fight. God wants you spreading the gospel. How impactful for the kingdom, or how powerful of an ambassador of Jesus Christ are you if you're laid up in a bed? If you're addicted to chemicals? If you can't get through your day without taking a Xanax? You can't sleep at night without an Ambien? You know what I'm saying? Or if I may, I am a 9-year veteran. I know a little bit about warfare. God has made me to be a warrior in the kingdom. I get energized from fighting the devil, okay? You may not, but this is who I am in the body of Christ. And I'm going to tell you, church, there's no place for me. You might say, hey, come to the prayer meetings or whatever, and we'll scoot off the demoniacs, you know, in a back corner and you know, whatnot, if that even happens. But there's countless times that I've shared with the pastors and like, hey, this is my giftings. I want to see your church free. I want to help out. You know, there's no place for me. Okay? If I may, warfare, right? What better tactic? And I'm going to say this. And I respect the devil, okay? I don't honor him. I don't give praise to him. But he is a tremendous foe. He is smarter than I am. He's smarter than you are. Okay, he's been around thousands and thousands of years, okay? He's good at his job. Everything he does is a deception. And you'll find out that this deception is buffered by this deception, is strengthened by this deception, and this is a stronghold of this deception, okay? So there's a network of lies that is pretty complex, all right? And I will say this, in a 2 to 3 hour session, demons that have been in your lineage for generations, okay, they've had hundreds, sometimes hundreds of years to build their kingdom in you. Jesus Christ and what he did on the cross comes in 2 to 3 hours, wipes them out. It's a beautiful, amazing, awesome thing. I'm about to cry. It is awesome. I never get bored of it. This energizes me, folks. To see demons of death, demons of depression, the biggest demons you could think of, flee at Yeshua's name or Jesus Christ's name. Don't crucify me if I say Jesus, all right? I would rather use Yeshua, the Hebrew version, but I'm not saying ISIS, okay, just because I say Jesus. Trust me, Jesus gets the job done, okay? I love seeing these demons cower and flee from Jesus, okay? It's a beautiful thing. So I'm going to show you step by step. This is going to be a comprehensive video of how you, okay, I'm nothing special. I'm nobody special. I just have Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, and this is my gifting. But according to Mark 16, if you believe in his name, you will be able to cast out demons, okay? Just like I'm not a prophet, but I have the ability to prophesy. Okay, and the Bible even encourages me to attain prophecy. Okay, so it's the same thing. I'm nobody special. That's why I'm teaching you step by step. You know, I need you to send me $1,000, a love gift first. Ha! Just kidding. That's another stupid thing that's going on. Jesus Christ said that the deliverance is the children's bread. How dare I charge you for the bread? Am I doing this video out of selfishness? Yes. I'll tell you why. Because I want to see you freed, because that helps the rest of the army, okay? And if God gives me something, I want to give it away because I want more. I want more. I'm going to give you everything that I have for free, okay? Everything in me, I'm giving it to you because I want more. And I'm not going to bury my talent. I'm not going to bury the things God has given to me because I'm going to be judged. And I want you to be free of diseases, of sicknesses, of evil thoughts, of depressions, of addictions. I want you free, okay? I want you a sweet, strong, awesome ambassador of Jesus Christ. That's my goal, okay? Let me pose this to you. You're not going to see this teaching in the church, and I'll tell you why. Think about how do you get to be a pastor or a leader in today's churches, for the most part. You go to school, right? You go to a Bible college, you go to a Christian college, whatever. And if you're a good student, you do your homework, you pass your tests, you'll get a piece of paper. And that piece of paper will most likely get your foot into a church. Start out, you know, they might test you and stuff. But I've been in so many accountability groups that say they're accountable. They're not accountable. Do they really pray that you're holy, that you're living a holy lifestyle? Do they know that you don't have any secret sins? If they did, then how did the BTK killer, bind, torture, kill, serial murderer, get to be the president of his elder board? Please tell me that. If our churches is so sweet on putting the right people in the right places, how does that happen? How does these other guys that are the head of the biggest churches in the city and are the president of the biggest Christian associations in the world are having homosexual massages while taking hits off of meth? How does that happen? Well, it happens because the church is set up to have man-made gates. And if you have a piece of paper, most likely you can pass through those gates. I know a little bit about warfare, folks. This isn't a theory. Okay, I'm not coming to you and say, yeah, you know, I heard this once and I think it's really cool. And hey, what about this lesson? This isn't practice, okay? I've seen people healed instantly. I've seen fruit instantly, long-lasting fruit. Okay, after, like I said, kingdoms of darkness have set up their kingdom for years and years and years. And to see Jesus Christ crush that with his truth, the truth will set you free in 2 to 3 hours. It's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing. Okay, I want to give this to you. Be excited. Don't be distracted right now. Don't get angry at me. Okay, I'm going to say some things. How dare you say I have a demon? How dare you say, you know, my mother was a beautiful, wonderful Christian woman and she died of cancer. And how dare you say that she had a demon and demons? Well, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. What better adjectives than cancer? Or what better adjectives than suicide and depression? And there's a battle, folks. And if you're a Christian and you're doing your job, you're on the front lines, okay? And most of you are on the front lines with one piece of armor, okay? With half a sword or a letter opener. And you're trying to fight this war. You're not doing very good, all right? That's why our churches are filled with cancer, filled with disease, depressed, suicides, murders, thievery, okay? I mean, I'm pretty emotional when it comes to this subject. Because God made me intense for a reason. And I'm speaking to a lot of warriors out there that you've never found your place in the church. And there's a reason why. They don't want you there. Because they want to perpetuate their demonic doctrines. Let me ask you this one question. How many times have you heard a sermon that they want you to know your giftings, to train you in those giftings, and to put those giftings into work? How many times have you heard that? I've heard it a lot. How many times have you seen it in action? You may have taken a gifts test and you know your giftings. What happens after that? Nothing. Have you been able to say, hey, these are my giftings. Where can I use these? Well, if it's not, you know, you can be on the prayer team, you know, but maybe we have to test you a little bit, see your character. That's fine. Maybe you can help feed the poor. That's fine. But what if you have a gifting that's biblical, but there's no place for you in church? What do you do? Do they really have classes for you to practice your giftings? If you feel like you have a prophetic gifting, do they have classes that allow you to practice this? Oh, practice your giftings. Oh my gosh. You know, no, you just need to go out there and be perfect in your giftings and know exactly how God works. Folks, I'll tell you this. Every deliverance that I do is different. And what I'm teaching you is not a formula. And I love that. I love that about this ministry is because it's not a formula. Because if it was a formula and all I had to go is step one, I'm going to make this prayer. Step two, I'm going to say this prayer. Hopefully you're good. Okay, cheers. If I did that, then I can control it. I have no need to rely on the Holy Spirit whatsoever, right? And that's what formulas do. That's what man's formulas do. I'm going to teach you principles, okay? Every deliverance that I go into, I have a framework that I go with, and I learn something new every single time. You want to know why? Because I have to depend on the Holy Spirit. I get stuck. God, why isn't this demon moving? Why is nothing happening? Holy Spirit, okay. You know, they'll get a picture, they'll get an event, they'll remember something that was deeply hidden in them. Have you forgiven your mom or, you know, whatever. It's awesome. It's awesome. I love it. Please be encouraged. This video is just an intro, just basically to say, I want to push your buttons, okay? But please, it's biblical. I'm going to give you scriptures. I'm going to back this up. I'm going to. Again, if you're a warrior out there too, so I'm speaking to Christians that think I'm full of garbage, okay? Please stick around. Please, 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 please. Please stick around. If you just want to watch me for entertainment, fine, that's fine, fine. But please stick around. Just allow me to get this in your spirit. Have the Holy Spirit. You know, let me just plant the seed, okay? I will allow the Holy Spirit to water it, okay? No problem. But some of you you've hit bottom. Just like an addict. If you haven't hit bottom and people try to send you to rehab, is it going to stick? Nope. Some of you haven't hit bottom. Some of you think that you're just being oppressed and you're just going to fight through it and pushing that boulder uphill every single day is tiring. It's not peaceful. You read about scriptures about peaceful and joy and all this stuff, and that's not you. I'm telling you why. This is the reason, okay? Because you've been taught that as long as you get saved and baptized and are speaking in tongues, there's nothing more for you, okay? Totally anti-biblical. Totally. Okay. And I'm going to prove it. Okay. Some of you are warriors in the kingdom that you don't know where you belong in this world. Yeah, that's me. I'm 35 and I'm so excited that I finally have found my place. You know, I want to go to college, right? The world tells you to go to college. I look through 200 things that I can be when I grow up. None of them sound interesting, to be honest with you. Maybe one or two, but I'll tell you, folks, if you're intense and you lived your whole life of like, why aren't you happy? Why aren't you more bubbly? Why aren't you more, you know what I'm saying? God made you intense for a reason, okay? You are where you need to be. Why do when you meet a stranger, okay, and within the first 5 minutes of talking to this person, they are telling you their deepest, darkest secrets that they've never told anybody ever, ever. Why does that happen? Because they trust you. They can feel that there's a spirit of truth and intensity, and they can trust you, all right? That's a gifting, a part of this ministry. Because when you do deliverance, you have to have that person trust you, okay? They need to know that you're going to protect their secrets, but we need to know where the enemy's foothold is. And 10 times out of 10 times, it's going to be where you're most hurt. The deepest, darkest secret that you've been hiding, that you've been stuffing down in the dark, is the source of the greatest, is the power source of those demons in your life. Okay? I'm going to share my testimony later in later videos. I'm going to be comprehensive. The next video, this is just the intro of just saying, hey, bear with me and be hopeful. And there's more for you, okay? And the reason why you're not hearing this, there's a reason, okay? It's not hard for Satan, who is smarter than we are, to put his demonic philosophy or even his demonic people, okay, into positions of power in the church. Why? Because it's a man's system. If you have that piece of paper, you can achieve a lot of things in the church on the corner. And it's unfortunate. You don't have to be holy. You don't have to, you know. And that's why we get such horrible stories. And we're not perfect. But it's easy for Satan to put his people in positions of power, okay? And they're satisfied with leaving you in the pews. Okay, as long as you're paying your tithes and you're faithful. I mean, look, they teach you hypocrisy. We don't care what you do during the week. As long as your butt is in that chair with a smile on your face and you're dressed the way Christians should be dressed, and you're saying the things that Christians should be saying, and you're giving the Christian wave, and you're wearing the Christian hat, you're good to go. That teaches you hypocrisy. They don't care what you did during the week. They might say, hey, how was your week? Ah, it was good. Fantastic, brother. They teach you to be a hypocrite, okay? But you could go out, deliver 500 demons, you can feed the poor, you can donate 2 of your kidneys over the week, right? And I know it's impossible, it's a joke. And come, but miss a Sunday? Oh my gosh, my backslidden brother. You know, it's... They like you in the pews, okay? Again, if we're really taught to be a part of the body and every single person has their purpose, has their place, has their gifting, and we're going to put it in the holy machine, the body, you're the elbow, you're the forearm, you're the thumb, you're the eyes, you're the ears. Let's put it together and go to the world, okay? Isn't that biblical, right? Does that happen? Have you seen that happen? No, we just gather around the elbow or the prophet or the pastor, right? And we just get spoon-fed. Are we effective? Are we dying? Are we abused? Are we diseased? Do we look like the world? There's a reason, folks. And this ministry is, I would say, about 1/4 or 1/3 of what Jesus Christ focused on. And it's nowhere to be found in 90% of the churches out there. I had to get delivered myself. I had to fly to Texas. All right. I live in California. I had to fly to Texas to get delivered. Okay. And you know where he was at? He wasn't in a church. He was in an office behind a secondhand store. This stuff is not mainstream. There's a reason. Am I getting through to you? I'm going to prove it biblically, but I just want to set this up. There's hope. Okay, there's more for you out there. And it's not through antidepressants. It's not through Xanax. It's not through meditation. It's not through the New Age. It's not through the occult. It's not through all this other stuff. There's peace for you. There's a way to stop being addicted to things. I'm excited. I hope you're excited. If you're upset and you're upset, please just stick around. I want to prove it to you biblically, okay? And I love you. So the next video I'm going to do is going to focus on why I believe biblically that Christians have demons. Okay, you're not possessed, but you have demons in you, okay? Not possessed. But you have demons in you, in your mind, in your body, in your soul, okay? Inside, well, your soul is your mind, feelings. You're being a puppet, right? You're not possessed because the Holy Spirit is in the Holy of Holies and nothing can enter there, but you're still a puppet for the world, okay? So a big part of that is forgiveness. So those are the two things I'm going to focus on. Why Christians have demons and forgiveness. That's the next video. Please stick around. I'm going to give you a how-to comprehensive on how to cast out devils, how to free your family, how to free yourself, how to free your church. This is awesome. I'm excited. This is timely. The occult is doing so many worldwide ceremonies tomorrow, and the occult is prevalent, right? I just saw a new show where, like, there's a Southern Belle, or no, a New Jersey witch, basically, that goes around and is a psychic, you know? This stuff is mainstream. The occult is mainstream. It's entertainment. Demons are more prevalent and are able to get inside you more now than ever. Okay? Ever. Mary Magdalene had 7 demons cast out of her. That was huge for them to put that in the Bible. I think, had like 30 some. Okay? There's princes, and I'll get into it and stuff. I'll get into the testimony. But back then, that was a Jewish, strict, conservative culture. Don't suffer a witch to live, all right? Nowadays, turn on your television and you get to be entertained by a witch. Go click on the internet and you get to see every single perversion, every single occult thing you could imagine, okay? So, folks, we're getting murdered on the front lines here, okay? I need you in the fight. I'm going to give this away. I love you. Hate me, love me, I don't care. I just, please, allow me to get the seed. Allow the Holy Spirit to get the seed in you. I'm going to biblically prove it. Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe Jesus Christ is come in the flesh, okay? So all the testing of the spirits that you want to do on me, I love you. God bless. Stick around.